Hey guys, welcome back to the shop for another week of Saturday Night Special, and I'm glad to be back and filming again and getting some of these projects done. So we took a little bit of time off, Abby and I, and for all you guys that may not know and don't follow me on Instagram or follow me on my adventures channel, Abby and I, we went and got married. We went to Las Vegas and we had us a nice honeymoon. We took us a little road trip after the Las Vegas wedding, and we went and seen some of the sites around the Southwest, and we went all the way over to Albuquerque and then flew back home. We had a great time. It wasn't quite 2 weeks, but we were gone close to 2 weeks, and we really enjoyed it and absolutely loved it. Abby and I both love the Southwest. We both have just a love for it and all the areas out there. And we really look forward to many, many more trips out there because there's so many great places to see. You just can't ever get them all in one trip. So there's places all over Arizona, Utah, New Mexico, Colorado, those kind of places that we would like to go and visit. So we had a great marriage. It was fun. We had some of the family there. And if you guys don't know about the A-Bomb Adventures channel, for all you people that's kind of new to my channel, I have a second channel. It's called A-Bomb Adventures. And there is the first video over there of our trip, and that's the wedding. We went to the Little White Chapel there in Las Vegas and got married there. So one of our family members, Shanley, she took the camera and actually got video of everything, so I was able to make a little video for you. So go check out that channel. I'll have a card up here and we'll have it in the video description down below, and give me a subscription over there. We've only got, like, I think there's like 9,000 subscribers on A-Bomb Adventures, so I don't guess very many of you guys want to watch those, but that is a place where we will be uploading our videos of the adventures that we took out in the Southwest. We went to some of the national parks, we went to some of the state parks, and other places like the Glen Canyon Gorge Bridge, Horseshoe Bend, and just places like that. And I'm gonna have little videos showing all those places. So go over there and check that channel out. And I really want to personally thank everybody that's been giving Abby and I support through this, through our marriage, and the gifts that had come in through the registry and things like that. Thank you very much. So on tonight's episode, what I want to do is I want to share some more viewer mail with you. I've got a couple of really nice gifts that's come in, and I'd like to share those because that's always awesome, the stuff that people make and send in here to the shop, okay? And there's been a lot of viewer mail coming in. I'm really trying to figure out how I can continue to share all that without taking too much of the SNS time slot out for you, but I definitely want to share a few of those that's been coming in there. And thank you everybody that's been sending me gifts, no matter if it's, you know, one tap that you send, a couple tool bits, or handmade gifts. I enjoy everything that everybody sends in. I really do. So we got that, and then we start a new project in this SNS, and it's the new collaboration project with Scott and Nate over at the Essential Craftsman YouTube channel. So I got to meet both of those guys whenever we went down to Texas for the Good of the Land Fest, and I talked with them and about helping them machine a handle for a Wilton Vise that they're restoring. So I got started on that, and we're going to go ahead and share some of that footage in this SNS. It's probably going to take a couple episodes to show it all, but I also got some of the footage from Scott and Nate that they took forging this handle. So that, I thought that was so cool that they shared that video, and I get to share that here on my channel for you guys to watch. So that's going to be in this episode, getting to see Scott forge that handle. And then we're going to get to the machining. We're going to go down, we're going to use our Monarch blade. I know you haven't seen that in a while. So we're going to use the Monarch, and we're going to use that to machine this Vise handle. So in case you guys missed it, I just had a video earlier in the week release of the new Dake Arbor Press that I got in. So I got a video share and getting that in here. And I got a little bit of video, just a few minutes to share with you, of actually moving it from here over to the other side of the shop. So we're gonna throw that in this episode so you can see where I put it. And then also just wanted to mention, I've got new jobs that I'm trying to get started and done around here. I've got a lot more jobs down here that I'm trying to get to. I've got some more collaborations. For all you guys that's been waiting for the collaboration projects to start, just please be patient with me, and we are trying to get to each and every one of them. I look forward to each and every one of them and sharing them here on the channel. All right, so let's go ahead and get to our viewer mail now. So this first gift right here come all the way from the Netherlands, and it come from Jared Burgers, and he sent me this cute little pocket-sized vernier caliper. In his letter, he says that he's been watching for several years, and he's always noticed that I've got like a, you know, one of my scales in my pocket. And he said that he thought it might be handy to have one of these little small vernier calipers around here. And I think it's funny, I've never really seen one this small before, especially like this. I think it's pretty cool. Even though it is metric, it's okay. It goes all the way to 7 centimeters. All right, so what, 70 millimeters is the capacity? But isn't that just a little cutie right there? All right, Jared, thank you very much. I really appreciate it, man. All right, so we've got 3 taps that were sent in by Tom Machinist. There's his decals right there he sent me so I can put on the toolbox. You can find him on Instagram, Tom_Machinist. There's some of his pictures of some of the work that he's done. Sent a very nice letter there. Said he's been watching for 3 years now. That's when he moved to the U.S. and wanted me to have these taps, and these are some really high quality taps. So you got a 12 millimeter and a 14 millimeter and then a 16 millimeter. So I actually welcome these kind of taps all the time into my shop whenever I can get them, because I don't have that many metric taps, and it seems like whenever I do have one, I just have like one tap of that size. So thank you very much, Tom. I'm going to put these over there in the Hewitt cabinet, and we'll be able to put them to use one day on the job, and we'll get your sticker up on the cabinet. All right. So we've got a very beautiful handmade gift. This is a wedding gift from my friend James Savage, and he's known as Savage Blades. You can find him on Instagram. And this is not the first time James has made some gifts for me. He's actually made several grilling utensils and another. He's made a cleaver and some grilling utensils and sent to me before, and does a really good job. He's a very, very knowledgeable blacksmith, very talented. And this is something that he forged up as a gift for an Abby and I. So thank you very much, James. Very, very cool gift right there. I really like it. So we got one more from James as well. Let me move that over here to the side. And this is something that I've been talking to James about since probably last summer. So I had asked him if he would be interested in making me a knife, and not just any knife. So there's a YouTube channel that I like to watch every now and then called the Almazan Kitchen. And these guys make some of the most beautiful cooking videos I've ever seen. They're all outdoors next to like a river, you know, places like that. It's just beautiful cinematography that they do. And they have their own style of knife that they like to use, and he uses it for everything. So I asked James if he wanted to make me one, and he did. So finally got it done, and he sent it to me, and he made the nice leather sheath to go there with it. So here's the knife that James made. Did a beautiful job on it. It looks just like the Almazan style of knife that they use on their channel. And then that's his that's James's hallmark that he puts in there, the Savage. Very nice job. Got the handle there. It looks really nice, and the nice leather sheath that fits it there as well. So I really appreciate it, James. Thank you very much. Make sure you go check James out on Instagram, Savage Blades. And then there's his card if you're interested in any of his bladesmith or some of his decorative, you know, blacksmithing type work there as well. So I got one more gift that I want to share with you on tonight's episode. So this super cool gift right here come from Steve Miller up from Trumbull, Connecticut. And I believe he said that he found this whenever he was cleaning out the basement. And as soon as he found it, he knew who it belonged to. He said he knew that he wanted to send it to me. So I want you to look at this. This is a super cool and probably rare, because I haven't ever seen one of these. So what it is a drill index made out of wood for the Morse Twist Drill and Machine Company. New Bedford, Massachusetts, USA is what it says there. I'm trying to give you guys a good shot of it. All right, so all you do is just pop the cap off just like that. And so it's for a number, it's for number drills. Very cool. That is just so cool, man. There's no telling how old that is. This is probably, if I had to guess, this is probably going way back to probably the 30s. Maybe even before that. I'm not sure. It's very possible this is older than that. Maybe the 20s, 30s. That's what I'm guessing. So just a super cool gift and another nice drill index to go to my collection. So thank you very much, Steve. I really appreciate it. This is a beautiful drill index, and I'm going to cherish having this one. Right about there up against the wall is where I want to put the Dake Arbor Press. That was about the best spot out of the way. And so I just rolled it all the way in here with the narrow pallet jack there. You use the cherry picker to pick it up and set it in place right there. So I'll just try to pick it up and see if I can't just kind of fish that pallet jack out of the way. Stupid casters down there are the death of me on that cherry picker. I want to throw that thing in the scrap pile and just replace it. I don't know if I can pull this thing out of here. It's pretty heavy. Like that. That's what I'm talking about. From there, I can just pinch it around with the pry bar to get it where I want. So, pretty much got her in place. I measured the height of the handle. It looked like it was just clear of my ceiling. Let's see. Oh, we need to go pull that one over there. Yeah. All right. That one's all the way in. No, it does. It does clear the ceiling, the top of the handle there. Very good. All right, there she sits. I had to put a couple shims in one corner because it was rocking on three, but it's nice and firm there now. So I still got to modify the pin for this side right there. And then we've also got to get the hand wheel for the other side, and we're gonna work on that later on, okay? So it is, other than getting it cleaned up and doing those two modifications, it's ready to use.
We're going to put this rough end in this ball die and see if we can hold these things up well enough to forge them. We had luck on the other end. Let's see what happened. We're going to refine it down a little further so we have a ball on each end. Run it through a rounding die in the middle, try to center everything up, see how we do. So this is a 3/4 inch rounding die. First time I've used it, since I got it from Bill Vianne 12 years ago. I love that, the luxury of going to the tool collection, finding what I need. We're going to try to refine that shaft down to an even 3/4 inch. Nice. I hope you can see that. We're getting close. One more heat. The wrong tongs on there and I couldn't twist it, so I've got to get it hot and try to work out some of those rags, but those will be turned off in the lathe anyway. Anneal it so it's soft and you won't have any trouble cutting it with high-speed tool steel, I would think. This is 5160, made out of an 1 3/8 inch diameter spring section. It's way bigger than A-bomb is going to need it to be, but he can turn it down. I'm hoping that this actually saves him a little effort. I'm going to put it in this forge and then shut the forge off and let it anneal. Actually, I'll let it come up to critical again and then shut the forge off and let it anneal. It should be nice and soft. We'll brush it up. Hopefully he'll turn it into something useful. I'm sure he will. That's 70 seconds. It's been in there and it's that critical. So I'm going to shut the forge down and let it soften. So what happens now is the inside of that forge is hot. That piece of carbon steel is way past critical temperature, so the grain growth is excessive. Wouldn't be ideal, certainly, for a knife. But as it slacks, as it cools down, it'll take it probably 3 hours to get down below about 600 degrees. And that should, as I understand it, give it time for everything to normalize and go back to its mild, unstressed condition. And at that point, A-bomb should have no trouble at all chucking it up, lathing, you know, peeling off whatever he needs to peel off. Hopefully I've got it straight enough that everything will remain concentric, that there's enough oversized to remove the aberrations of forging and get it down to the size that Wilton would have put on the handle had they made it here in the shop today. Anyhow, I just can't wait to see how he pulls this off. Besides that, I can't wait to meet him. See you in Texas.
Out of a railroad spring, big X out thing. So I normalized it. You know, I just left it in there critical and shut off the forge and said probably 4 hours to get done 6 weeks.
Yeah.
Everything else at your discretion.
Yeah, I think that'd be cool. I really like that. That's you. You know, this is something that you made, and then we'll add a little bit of the manual machining element to this to this piece, so we can make this, you know, the proper diameter to fit through there.
Yeah.
One side, it's probably going to be good, but we'll keep thinking on that.
Yeah.
And the other side, we'll see about having some kind of unique way to reattach the ball on this end right here.
Yeah. Anything you think will work will be perfect.
Okay.
It's a cool. You know, people don't realize that so many big pieces are forged and then machined. They're just oblivious to that. YouTube share thing is exactly the same thing.
It is. And you have a different background and experiences in doing things that I don't know how to do or never have done. You know, not that I couldn't, but
vice versa.
You know, and then you don't really do any machining yourself. So
I have a drill press. That's it.
Okay.
You know?
So I'm happy to be a part of it.
It's cool.
It's gonna be really cool.
So, you know, in the future, moving forward, I'll probably hire you for some projects. You know, separate from the channel collaboration. I think it's nice to know somebody who really knows this.
I'll be glad to help.
Yeah. And it's really been great.
Yeah.
Keep up the life of the world.
All right. You're gonna keep doing it, man. I look forward to this project. It's gonna be great.
All right, we got both ends welded up to what I believe should be built up to where it will machine and clean up. I'll do a little bit of grinding on there by hand with a side grinder just to kind of get the high spots down. And then after that, after it cools, because it's real hot right now, we'll go back to the lathe and start doing our machining.
And it's sort of easy, you know, once you become more effort,